Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. This is episode 101 of the Internal Style Lecture Series. Last week's video was the 100th video in which I announced the creation of a non-profit organization, Daoist Arts Organization International, or DAOE. Today, I'd like to announce the launch of the DAOE website. The address is daoe.org or daoi.org. So far, we only have the basic site ready, and there's not a lot of content in there. However, our team is currently working on it, and I will announce updates as and when they are ready. Like I said in my 100th video, DAOE belongs to the community. In order for DAOE to grow and flourish, we need your advice. We would like to hear your suggestions, recommendations, and expectations from DAOE. Again, any advice is good advice. So I request you use the contact form on the DAOE website to express your interest and to let us know your suggestions. That was about it in terms of announcement. Let's get on with today's topic. Today, I'd like to introduce a new term, Li Dian, used in the internal style community. The operative word being new here because this term has only about a few decades worth of history in the martial art community. Li Dian originally is a concept in physics. It is also used in areas that apply physics such as construction and mechanics to describe different scientific concepts. We know that the human body is a very complicated system. It becomes even more complicated when analyzing a martial art movement since it involves body structure, speed, intention, different muscle groups, and physiological factors, among many other factors. However, one of the solutions to turn a concept related to a complicated system into a comprehensive and practical technique is to first break down a phenomenon into some specific terms. Li Dian actually is a result of such methodology. By the way, in my recent monthly Q&A 13th, Cesar Escalante asked a question about Li Dian and I gave a brief answer. Let's watch that clip first. Cesar Escalante asks, could you explain what Li Dian means in Tai Chi Chuan? Thank you. The term Li Dian consists of two characters. Li means force or power. Dian means point. Put together, Li Dian is the point to apply power or force. So, where exactly is the Li Dian in martial practice? Well, whenever you strike your opponent, the area of contact on the opponent's body is considered Li Dian since you have to release power or force on that point. Li Dian is a relatively new term and have been gaining popularity in the last couple of decades ago. There are some interesting practices involving Li Dian which I will introduce in the future, but I hope this answers your question for now. Let's move on to the next one. Due to the nature of the monthly Q&A videos, I could not elaborate on Li Dian in detail. Today, let me elaborate on Li Dian. It is worth noting that even though Li Dian may be a simple topic, you already expect that I will not be merely skimming the surface. Instead, I will elaborate it in a much more detailed manner. So, it will be an abstract topic, and you may need to rewatch the video in order to fully digest it. Topics covered in today's video include: first, What is 立点? Second, how to practice 立点? Third, key principles of 立点. Fourth, demonstration. Fifth, correction of students' practice. And sixth, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. What is 立点? 立点 consists of two characters. 立 means force or power, and 点 means point or spot. So, I define 立点 as the point of a contact between the two parties engaged in combat. Originally, Wang Xiangzhai used the term 立点 in a couple of his articles, including拳经术境, or martial art classic teaching, and his teaching notes. Unfortunately, some martial art research experts suspect the authenticity of these articles were written by Wang Xiangzhai himself. In other words, researchers suspect that those articles were written by his students but published under his name after Wang Xiangzhai passed away. So, whether those articles were written by Wang Xiangzhai himself or not, the term 立点 has been mentioned a few times in his documents, including the 拳经术境. However, Wang Xiangzhai did not explain or define 立点 in his writings, since he only used 立点 to express some theory of his practice. As a result, 立点 was mainly used in Yichuan. But 立点 is a comparatively newer term to the internal styles, and the martial art community started gradually and widely using it about 3 decades ago. One of my Tai Chi teachers, Ma Hong, always used 立点 in his teaching. 立点 was and still is used in Tai Chi practice more often than other styles due to some specific characteristics of Tai Chi application. For example, very often, there are many Qin Na or joint locking techniques in Tai Chi practice, and many of those techniques are based on the concept of leverage, a very common concept in physics. In physics, especially when talking about leverage, 立点 describes the point where forces will be applied in order to generate a bigger effect on the other end of the leverage. And Tai Chi Qin Na or Tai Chi joint locking techniques are very often explained in terms of leverage. With time, Tai Chi teachers started using the term 立点 to express the point used in Tai Chi Qin Na techniques. 立点, a term originally used in Yichuan, was also adopted later by others. When comparing and analyzing Wang Xiangzhai's writing to that of the concept of 立点 in the context of Tai Chi, however,the meaning has slightly changed. In other words, 立点 used in Tai Chi Pushhand or Qin Na practice is different from the concept of 立点 in Wang Xiangzhai's articles. About 20 years ago, some Xingyi and Bagua teachers, including yours truly, started using this term as well. I started using this term about 20 years ago in describing the specific place that I will release the power in Fa Jin action. In this video, I will explain both the meaning of this term used in Qin Na and Tai Chi Pushhand and in Xingyi Bagua practice. It's worth noting that 立点 is popular only among advanced level practitioners and teachers.I believe that by applying 立点 in explaining martial practice, especially in pushhand and combat applications, 立点 can play a very effective and efficient role in explaining internal style practice. So, to summarize, Lidian is a term used in the internal styles indicating the point at which both parties make contact in martial application. It sounds very simple, but easier said than done. Because it is not that easy to control the direction of our own force in the opponent's body. It's worthwhile to elaborate on its practice in more detail in today's video, which brings us to the next topic. Topic 2. How to practice Lidian. I have introduced my own definition of Lidian in the previous section. Now I'd like to introduce how to practice Lidian in martial art. Well, you have to know that even though Lidian is a physical area on the body, it is more importantly a concept. You cannot practice Lidian alone on a specific point which requires the involvement of your opponent. So, we have to understand the concept of Lidian first. In order to make Lidian easier to understand, I will now introduce three more terms to help us break it down. Those are first, 接触点, or point of connection, third person POV, second, 施力点, or point of application, initiator's POV, and the third, 受力点, or point of bearing, recipient's POV. Let's look at them one by one. The first point, 接触点, or point of connection, is the area that connects the body parts of both the initiator and the recipient. 接触点 is from a neutral or third-person point of view. The second point is 施力点, or point of application, which is the point where the initiator releases force on the recipient's body. The third point is 受力点, or point of bearing, which is the area where the recipient receives the attack. Simply put, all three points, 接触点, 施力点, and 受力点, or the point of connection, application, and bearing, effectively mean the same point, but are described from different point of view. Also worth noting, even though these terms contain the word point, it does not mean a dimensionless point as defined in geometry, but rather means an area of the body. So, when the initiator and recipient make physical contact during combat, for example, their arms strike, the initiator reaches their point of application, which is also the point of connection. Likewise, the recipient receives the initiated force at the point of bearing, which again is the same as the point of connection. The point of connection or 接触点 is the neutral term including both point of application or 施力点 and the point of bearing or 受力点 respectively to initiator and recipient. Now, let me introduce another term, 作用点, or point of effect, which is an advanced detail in Lidian practice. 作用点 is a place in the opponent's body where the force is ultimately aimed at. Let me be clear, the point of bearing is not to be confused with point of effect. They could be the same, but often in advanced techniques, they are not. When the initiator added a force to the point of application, the force can reach another area of the recipient's body through the point of bearing, and that intended final destination of the force is called point of effect. For example, when two arms cross each other at 接触点, or point of connection, the final target of the force can be the center line of the body. Even though, from the initiator's perspective, the 实力点, or the point of application, is on the arm, the real target may be the central line of the recipient's body. So, I call the center line of the recipient's body the point of effect, or 作用点. Very often, in advanced techniques, the 接触点, or point of connection, is not the point of effect, or 作用点 at all. So, the differentiation of 接触点, or point of connection, and the 作用点, or the point of effect, makes the internal styles of martial arts more interesting and effective, which is the result of highly coordinated body movement and the mind, which also has been emphasized many times in many of my prior videos. Therefore, 立点 practice, which involves understanding the concept of 立点 and then applying it in martial application situations, requires practitioners to master it by working with a partner, which can greatly accelerate progress. Understanding the concept without any partner practice will only take you so far. Again, martial art practice is an art of doing, not an art of knowing, which I have emphasized in my 99th lecture. Since 立点 is an area on the body where both the initiator and the recipient make contact, I will talk about some practice based on each of these two roles. The initiator's objective normally is either to change the current status of the recipient body part. For example, a movement such as parrying can be used to move your opponent's hand away or send the force to the opponent's body through the point of connection to the point of effect. For example, the center line. So, the objective of a movement often does not end at the moment when the initiator and the recipient make contact at the point of connection or 接触点. Rather, the final objective is most often the effect after force reaches that specific point. So, how to act or react from the perspective of initiator or recipient respectively actually becomes the key question. Instead of listing all of the possibilities, I will only briefly introduce some key points here. First, as the initiator, the point of effect is different from the point of application. It requires the initiator to release the force in a precise manner so that it will reach the point of effect, which requires a lot of practice in order to get it, since your opponent is in a dynamic state and the point of effect is often a moving target. From this perspective, you have to practice this technique under different situations in order to ensure the effectiveness of this movement. Any great result requires a lot of practice. Second, as the recipient, one effective solution in a combat situation is to hide or change the 作用点 or point of effect. By doing so, the force executed by the initiator will not be able to reach the point of effect, even though it reaches the point of bearing. Even better, by applying certain techniques, such as neutralizing force on the point of bearing by the recipient, the expected effect from the initiator on the recipient can be dramatically reduced. To summarize, I have introduced some terms in order to clearly explain 立点. Those terms may exist in physics, but then again, internal styles also use physics. By now, you should have a good understanding of 立点 and how to practice 立点. You should also be aware of the fact that Lidian is dynamic both in concept and practice. To practice Lidian, you absolutely need a partner in order to accelerate your progress. So, does Lidian in the context of the internal styles have any basic principles? This brings us to the next topic. Topic 3, key principles of Lidian. Now, I'd like to introduce 3 basic principles that I created in order to help you understand Lidian better. They are, first, 进攻以点透线，以点打点。Translation, as the initiator, use the point to penetrate the line and use a point to strike a point. Second, 防守，以点变现，闪点藏点。Translation, as a recipient, changing the point to a line so that the 立点 can be changed or hidden.And the third, 擒拿，锁在局部，力打远端。Translation, in 擒拿 techniques or joint locking, lock locally but send the force further. Now, let me briefly explain them one by one. First, as the initiator, use the point to penetrate the line and use the point to strike a point.The initiator uses a point to penetrate the opponent through a line so that the force will transfer through the point of application to the point of effect. Use the point to penetrate the line and use the point to strike a point. Like I have mentioned in the prior section, the skill of a Lidian practice is to be able to send the force through point of application.To the point of effect. In order to achieve this result, the initiator has to visualize the invisible line between the point of application and the point of effect. In the internal styles, an advanced level of practice is to manage and manipulate many invisible lines between the initiator and the recipient. So, the practice is to use thepenetrative force moving through the invisible line to the point of effect. I will elaborate on this topic more in the future. Second, to recipient, change the point to a line so that the Lidian can be changed or hidden. In a situation where a recipient needs to define themselves by changing the Lidian orhiding the Lidian so that the initiator will not be able to have any effect on the recipients since the Lidian is hard to grasp. So, the ability to quickly change the Lidian or even hide the Lidian is the practical strategy in this situation. One effective solution is to extend the Lidian to a line so that the initiator's forceMoves along the invisible line and ends up at the point where the initiator's attacking force cannot reach the point of effect. Of course, easier said than done. It requires a lot of practice. I will elaborate more on this in the future. Third, in 擒拿 techniques or joint locking, lock locally but send the force further.It is worth noting that in 擒拿 practice, you should pay special attention to the concept that the locking technique is done locally, but the effect should extend beyond the point of connection. This is an advanced level of practice. You will need to test this concept with a partner in order to grasp it. Again, principles without physical movements and the practiceWill not have much effect, even more so when you are dealing with an abstract concept like Lidian. So, please find a practice partner and try to testing those principles and you will see the result very fast. To summarize, Lidian is a term used to describe an area of the body where two people make a contact in a combat situation. Many techniques can occur after this event. The ability to transmit your force within your opponent's body to reach the desired point of effect is an advanced level of practice, which should be practiced with a partner in order to master this skill in a timely manner. Topic 4. Demonstration. I'd like to demonstrate the Li Dian concept from two examples. The first one is a short clip of one of my old videos. I think many of you have watched it.
Try this kind of move. This kind of move. Yeah. It's not like this. Again. Again. Try this.
The second one is Li Dian practice in pushhand. I will demonstrate a point of effect by applying a force on the point of application. Hello, I'd like to demonstrate the concept of point of effect and the point of connection with my student in a pushhand setting. So now, move back a little bit. So we practice pushhand, get a chin style pushhand. Then now, at this moment, don't move. Here is my contact point of connection. Point of connection. Here's like leverage, locking. But my intention, my idea to make this movement work is not at this area. It's somewhere else. For example, his shoulder. See? Let's continue, okay? Just continue. Now, see? First go to his shoulder. Now I will try to go to his hip. Okay, then go to his hip. Then continue. Now I try to continue again. Now I try to move upward. So this is the differentiation, continue, between the point of connection to the point of effect. Okay. So based on this Li Dian principle. Thank you. Topic 5. Correction of a student's practice. Okay, let my students demonstrate the Xing Yi Ba Gua Palm exercise, then I correct his movement. Okay. Yes, 1, continue, 2, 3, continue, 4. Okay, pretty good. Now you start from the beginning. Okay, now you can face to the camera. Then, another set here. Yes, let's start. Okay. First of all, for the standing posture, 1, 2, elbow keep space between the rib cage area. Then extend. When you extend, still keep at distance. Yes, like this. This is the Cheng style palm. Cheng Xin Bao come like this. Yes. Then start to walk. Yes, for this posture, very good. Then open more, very good. Then the shoulder extend more, right. Then start to walk. You can change the place. 1, 2, 3. Then stop at here. So this part did good, like 1, 2. Then when you close this posture, you can back a little bit. This posture. Then more space, and like this, not like, yes, right. Then 1, open the finger, then 2, open, then start to walk, then keep space, keep going, then you can stop. Yes, thank you, very good. Topic 6. Takeaways. First, I define Li Dian as the point of contact between the two parties engaged in combat. A simple concept but requires a lot of practice in order to be effective in combat. Second, Li Dian can be explained in terms of 4 points. First, 接触点, point of connection from a neutral perspective. Second, 施力点, point of application from the initiator's perspective. Third, 受力点, point of bearing from the recipient's perspective. And the fourth, 作用点, point of effect need not be the same as the point of bearing.And three, you absolutely need a partner for Li Dian practice. Four, key principles of Li Dian are, first, 进攻以点透线以点打点 translation, as the initiator use the point to penetrate the line and use the point of, to strike a point. Second, 防守以点变现闪点藏点 translation, as the recipientchange the point to a line so that the 力点 can be changed or hidden. Third, 擒拿所在局部力达远端 translation. In 擒拿 techniques or joint locking, lock locally but send force further. Do not forget to check out the demonstration and the student correction sections to get a better idea of a 力点 practice. That brings us to the end of today's video.Thank you for watching. See you next time and find a partner and enjoy your Li Dian practice.